May Lee's fairly similar. She's got about 20 bigs. Paul Jackson, he's down to just under 30,000. So that must have been the flip that he was in. Looks like Watto, Steve Watts has won a, he's won another main event at the Fox, the Genting at the Fox. Another 12,000. This boy runs good. He's a great player. We love Steve Watts. Oh, we got some action here. Oh, I like this flat behind from Tom. It's been raised by Melis with ace queen. He's set the trap hoping for a squeeze play to come somewhere with aces. Called by the ace eight. I don't like this call. I'm sorry, this is a really bad call with ace eight. And Joe's in a small blind. I'm sure Joe is. Well, it looks like he's got the money in front of him. He should be calling to set mine. He's got the stack.
These are the pre-flop raises, and the percentage.
Cards have gone off the screen. Has Paul Jackson shoved? Well, it does look like a good spot. I haven't seen what Paul's got. Paul knows there is 24 times 5 in the middle, which is 12,000. He thought he probably only had to get through one person, but he was unfortunate to find a guy with boots behind.
Trying to divide his phone.
Can't really see what's happening, guys, sorry. As soon as we can find out, I'll let you know. Well, Joe's thinking about this with pocket twos he had. I can't imagine Joe's going to be putting a large amount of his stack into this pot with pocket twos. It is pulled all in. I'm sure I saw someone with aces earlier. I don't know where those aces have disappeared to, unless they were pulls.
Yeah.
Malus is all in as well. And, well, I'm sure there was a guy sitting behind with aces. And Paul's got the remainder of his stack in. Well, we know Tom had aces. Malus has got ace queen. And we don't know what Paul Jackson's got. It looks like. It looks like kings. It looks like kings, but I can't be sure. We're going to see the flop turn and river. They're on their backs. It doesn't look like anyone's caught any of this. It looks like runner, runner for a gut shot. Well, that looks like a king on the turn, so maybe it's queens for Paul. Looks like a brick on the river, and that was a big pot.
Now the aces have stood up.
We've just lost two players. We've lost Malus Boardman and Paul Jackson here at the feature table.
Well, not the best day in the office for Paul Jackson, and just exited with a massive coup.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'd got my stack up quite good to like 50,000. I mean, everything I seemed to be doing was going wrong, and Steve Warburton was on the table, and like he's a cracking cash player, and obviously a very good poker player. And he sort of owned me in a few hands, and I nearly made an out. I don't even know what he had yet, but the flop was queen. On the turn, it was queen, 9-7. And I said, C bet the flop, and C bet the turn, trying to rep a queen, and then he re-raised me. And I thought the only hands he could possibly have here, and I nearly made a ridiculous hero call for like, yeah, another 5,000, but then I have to call his 14 grand shove, subject to the river, but on basically, if nothing changes. Because I figured that he's going to make that move with A, a queen, B, a full house.
Yeah.
But most flowers means he's probably got a pair pre-flop, which he's probably going to free bet me because I've raised quite late. So all the draws he could have, which is a flush draw and obviously all the straight draws, he's making the same move with. And obviously, I've only got king eye, I'm beating all those.
Yeah.
But obviously, it's a bit of a hero call to be calling off five and then another 14, which is like 20 odd grand. So I ended up folding that. And then a couple more hands, he either outplayed me or had a better hand, I don't know which. But I mean, he's certainly well capable of outplaying me. And I went card dead for about an hour, and then like I've got 30 odd thousand, which is still a decent stack.
Yeah.
And I'm in the big blind, and Malus has got a total of about 15. She raises it to like 2,500, I think, or 2,300. And one lad next to her calls, and about three more people call. I mean, I was planning on squeezing after just one had called, but I mean, I say squeezing, I'm trying to make it look like a squeeze. I'm in the big blind with queens. But when three people have called, now it looks like, you know, I can do that with almost anything. So I make it 15,000, which sets Malus all in effectively. She calls, the other lad calls, everybody else folds. Joe Beavers thinks about it for a bit, but eventually falls. And I've only got 15,000 left now, so there's like 60 odd thousand in the pot, and I got 15,000 left in queen, so I'm just betting that pre-flop before the flop even comes down. And Miley has ace queen, and the other lad's got aces. So, I mean, I don't really think there's much of a way I could have played it where I can get out of it when I've only got 30,000. That's like 33, 34 big blinds. But certainly the way that's played out with me being in the big blind and raising half my stack, it's just never ever going to work for me anyway. So.
And you had a tough table all day, didn't you? The names on
it. Well, we had some cracking players. I mean, I actually jokingly said, can we have Steve Warburton on here? Because like, he was the best player I could see while I was sat down. When I've got Chaz and Joe to my right.
Yeah.
And then there's at least another one player to my left, the one who had the aces, he was a decent player. And I never had a table where there was someone giving the money away. Like, there's plenty of tables where people are giving it away. There was none on my table. I mean, I jokingly said, can we have Steve Warburton? And then, like, 10 minutes later, he gets put across to the table.
Oh, I should be sat down. So, Genting sponsor, bro, Maylis Boardman. Maylis, just not a good day at the office, was it?
No, not a good day at the office at all.
And we've just seen the re-entry. We've just seen the exit of the re-entry.
Yeah.
It was a funny hand.
Well, to be honest, I was like, I only had like 15 big blinds, and because I raised in quite early position, there were so many callers, I thought Paul might be making a move by putting 15,000 in to get everybody off it, because it's quite a good pot. So I figured like I might be ahead of Paul. So I figured if I shoved, then it'd just be me and Paul. I had suited ace queen. I thought, yeah, it'll be all right.
Yeah.
But obviously he's got queens and he's got aces, so I was not in a good shape. Yeah,
not at all. It was a bit of a bad coup to be in position. How was the first buying? What went wrong there?
I was just card dead really, and then I lost a hand with kings when an ace came on the turn. And yeah, basically, you know, everything you try and do just doesn't work.
Yeah.
Like any cards you do get, like none of my pairs tripped up. Every time I tried to raise, somebody three bet me, or I wouldn't hit the flop, and then somebody would be betting, and it just wasn't my day.
Yeah, how was your table in the early stages? People on it you knew?
Yeah, Mark McCluskey was on, Rob Swindles, Yeah, everyone's friendly. Everyone's really nice.
Yeah. And I noticed that a lot of, I was just speaking to Paul Jackson, he was in a bad spot all day. He's got Joe Beavers to one side, Chas Chatter to another side. He's got names everywhere.
Well, Chas was moaning because he had them two to his left. So, like, I guess they all kind of respect each other, but yeah, you'd want a soft table if you can get it, I guess. Yeah.
What's next for you?
Moving house.
You are.
Just tell
everybody how you decided. You've moved to London.
Yeah.
You've been in Preston forever.
Yeah.
You moved to London.
Yeah.
And you've bought. You looked at, what is it, 50 houses.
Yeah. In two weeks,
and you found two.
Yeah.
And you couldn't decide. So what did you do?
So I said, I'm going to flip a virtual coin, because I literally was split, like, could not decide, no way I could decide. So I just said, heads or tails, write it on Facebook and Twitter, and whoever the majority wins, that's one I'll take. And I did, that was the only way I could decide.
So has anybody ever bought a house asking friends and family on Facebook which one it is, A or B? Nobody's ever seen the house, by the way, have
no.
They? It's not exactly, literally, it was A or it was B. And we decided on B. What was
Tails
it?
Tails never fails, apparently.
Tails never fails. So we've now got a house in London. Hopefully it's the right one. You just never know. But what a way to get one.
The universe is kind to me generally, so I reckon it'll be all right.
Excellent stuff. Well, fingers crossed. We better look at the poker tails next time. We'll see you soon.
Thank you.
Nice one, Maylee. Cheers. Back to you two in the commentary.